Hey folks, today I'm going to teach you how you can do some presentation in Schoology's conferences. This should be the screen that you see when you log in. And today I'm going to go over some basics that if you are given some presenter rights, so if there's a project or something where you need to present and it's a virtual setting like we've had this last year in 2020, that you're prepared for that. So first off, I like to upload all of my students' PowerPoints and slides and everything myself, so that way I have a little bit more control over that. But if you have another teacher or professor who doesn't mind that you have your file and are able to do that themselves. So first off, what you're going to notice is that, you know, I've got everyone muted and everything right now. Just surely out of convenience, and we're not getting all the echoes while I'm doing this recording. But you'll see your name up here, and it's just going to have, you know, either your picture or your initials. So when it's your turn, or if you have something to present or what have you, ask your teacher, or your teacher will tell you when they are going to make you a presenter. So right now on my screen, I'm making student the presenter, and now you'll notice that there's that little screen icon went from myself or the teacher over to you. So that means that you are now the presenter. You'll also notice this plus sign shows up, so we'll do that one more time just so you can see it. So if I take this back, or the teacher takes this back, you'll notice that plus sign goes away, and then the little screen goes back to the teacher. And then when you're made presenter, boom, there it goes. Everything shows up. So let's say, you know, if, like I said, in my classes, I'm going to preload the files, but let's say that day you just forgot or something, or you have another teacher that wants you to do that on your own. You're going to click on this little plus. Upload presentation, click here, and then you'll find what you need. Hit open, and then finally you're going to hit upload, and it'll kind of do its thing in the background, so you kind of have to wait. And there it is. So now you could go through and do what you need on the slides. Now, the problem with this versus being in class and presenting it that way is that you are not able to do any of the macro functions in your presentation. You can share your screen, the application window, if you like. That's a different option that you would have as well. But this is kind of like a little bit a neater thing, and that way you don't have to worry about if other applications or things pop up that you don't want other people to see. So like if you've got an email and your best friend emails you and says, oh, my dog just died, you don't want to have that being shared to everybody in your class. The other thing that this allows you to do, which will be very helpful, is going to be sharing videos. So if you have a YouTube video that you want to share, let's go over to YouTube. I'll just share this because why not? So you'll just go down here to the share button. And you'll copy the link. And you'll come over here, share an external video, and then you could just literally pop the link right in there. And it'll start playing. Then you have options on the start and stop the video wherever you like. So that's kind of a handy thing. So again, you can present by sharing, because again, this is a student screen. You can share your screen, the application window, and find your PowerPoint, and then run things off of there. But the problem with that is that if things pop up, like if you've got a link or something in your PowerPoint, then it's going to pop up and you're going to have to switch things around and it gets very awkward. If you do have your video embedded into your PowerPoint or slide, which there is a video on that, if you're interested on my channel, how to do that, then, you know, it becomes less of an issue. But again, this is kind of the simplest way, basic PowerPoint, throw it on there. And then if you need to get a video to the rest of the class, then just come here to the share external video and pop the link right in there. Basic stuff. So again, I just wanted to make sure that you knew how to do that. So that way when we present, you can kind of do that a little bit more seamlessly. And there you go. If you have any questions, let me know. And if not, I will see you next time.